Hello, Excellians, and welcome back. I'm Jessie. Before we begin this lesson, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons below in order to keep following these lessons and keep following me. Today, we have a new kind of video designed to help improve your writing. Forget those boring, simple, and compound sentences. Let's learn how to spice them up. In this video, we'll look at some relatively easy ways of expanding sentences with sentence starters, which are words or phrases in a sentence that come before the main clause. The first type of sentence starter you can use to spice up your sentence is paired adjectives. You probably already know that adjectives describe nouns, but when you pair them at the beginning of a sentence, they must describe the subject. Now let's look at some examples. Exhausted and hungry, Joe searched the refrigerator for a snack. I get you, Joe. I'm the same way. In this example, note that the paired adjectives exhausted and hungry both describe Joe, the subject of the main clause. Now, let's see how the sentence looks if we add a bit more to the sentence starter. Exhausted and hungry after the long bike ride, Joe searched the refrigerator for a snack. Here, the paired adjectives still describe Joe, but we have added the prepositional phrase after the long bike ride for extra description and interest. Another note, although we're learning about sentence starters, keep in mind that you can always use paired adjectives to describe nouns in other parts of the sentence. For example, Joe searched the refrigerator for a delicious and satisfying snack. Now let's look at the second type of sentence starter, paired adverbs. This type is similar to paired adjectives, but modifies the verb instead of the subject. Let's take a look. Calmly and quietly, Joe cradled his sleeping baby. Here, the starter adverbs describe how Joe cradled his baby. Now let's look at another variation, opposite adverbs. Angrily yet carefully, Joe copied down the last minute notes for his boss. In this singular variation, the conjunction yet shows that the words paired together will not be equal. The word angrily is negative, but the word carefully is positive. When pairing opposite adverbs or adjectives, be sure to use the conjunctions that show a contrast, such as but and yet. Well, that's it for today, everyone. Once you've mastered these, check next week's video for some more challenging sentence starters. See you then!